I'm going to read from my chapbook called Nietzsche is a Girl. Prologue. What is good is what is pretty and what is stirring. We know too little and are bad learners. This is why we need to lie. First part. Because we know too little and are pretty and are bad learners, we need to lie and be stirring. Gladly we pose as reconcilers, but do not always think sufficiently. Nietzsche is a girl, and life wants to build itself to heights of nature with pillars and sufficient steps. Life wants to be a tarantella dancer or at least be able to afford to dress itself the way it imagines. Life wants to be a boyfriend for Shawnee and Kathleen. But it also wants to be a free spirit, a foe of fetters, a non-endurer, a hermit in the woods. This is the initial conflict. Interlude. Girl Nietzsche arranges her hair this morning. Girl Nietzsche feels calm. Girl Nietzsche thinks about how to improve her life and finances. Girl Nietzsche knows she is excellent because it is so, so obvious. Fifth part, reading and writing. It's no easy task to decipher unfamiliar blood. Luckily, all blood is familiar to Girl Nietzsche. I hate bleeders, but I know all their sisters' birthdays, says Kathleen. Life wants to bleed on my sheets, but not in the way you're thinking, says Shawnee. You can always write stuff in blood and mail it to that old shriveled boyfriend, says Girl Nietzsche. Sigh, Girl Nietzsche. I love the brave. I love the bravery of the textured hosiery. I love the impropriety of footwear, the starless canopy, the mountain's tacky perfume, the spit curls. Everyone is allowed to bleed standing in the middle of the row, but what of it? I find myself serious, profound, and bleeding, but what of that? Only this. Blood makes a pretty face prettier. This is truth at its most